welcome to this video tutorial. So today we will be discussing about financial checkup and goal setting workshop. If you remember, in our Building Your Future orientation, we discussed about the membership benefits, and the second benefit of being an IMG member is the free financial checkup. Before I proceed with the training, I'd like to explain first what is the importance of having a financial checkup. Like in our health, we do physical checkup para malaman natin kung meron tayong sakit. Equally important, kailangan din natin malaman kung okay ba yung finances natin. And the best way para malaman natin yun or ma-figure out natin kung what's the status of our finances is to undergo financial checkup. So in this video tutorial, I will be teaching to you or I'll be showing to you kung paano natin ginagawa ang financial checkup sa IMG. It's very easy, anyone can do it. Basta pag-aralan lang mabuti, intindihin lang because it's very simple. So with this financial goal setting and financial checkup training, dito natin malaman paano natin na-execute. What are the first steps para ma-build natin yung solid financial foundation natin? Okay? So ipakilala ko lang ulit yung sarili ko. I'm Realyn Fabillar, and together with my husband, we are doing tutorials like this because we decided to be part of the campaign of IMG to educate Filipino families so that we can empower them about their finances. Since we want to reach out to more Filipinos, we do video tutorials like this para hindi lang yung mga nasa vicinity namin yung kaya namin i-educate, but also those people na gusto nilang matutunan how to handle their finances pero medyo malayo. So we send out these videos like this para hindi man namin kayo kasama physically. Through videos like this, ma-share namin kung ano yung mga natutunan namin sa IMG. So Andre and I are both CEO Marketing Directors of International Marketing Group. We are both licensed associate financial planner, and we've been part of the company since September 2012. So whatever it is na isi-share namin dito sa video na to at sa mga susunod pang video tutorials are basically the things that we learn in IMG and have been applying to our financial life from 2012. And I must tell you, these are financial concepts na talagang nakapagbago ng finances naming dalawa. So through IMG, It's financial education and concept. From an employee, kami po ay naging entrepreneur, also became an investor. So in this workshop, you will learn the following. So you will know what you want and why you want it. So it's very important, no? Dapat naiintindihan natin, what are our goals? Bakit tayo nag-decide to become part of IMG? Second, we have to know where you are now. So we will find out in this financial checkup and goal setting, paano ba mag-compute ng net worth. Next, know why you're in your present situation. So after natin malaman what is your present situation right now, titingnan din natin bakit tayo nandun sa sitwasyon na yon. So malalaman natin yun by knowing your cash flow statement. Okay, know what you can get with what you have right now. So, ibig sabihin, kapag nalaman na natin, what do we have right now? Ano na yung naumpisahan natin? Meron na ba or wala pa? From that, ano pwede nating idagdag or umpisahan in terms of building your solid financial foundation? So, know what you want and how to get it. Know if you can get what you want. And know what it takes to get what you want. So basically, dito iikot ang ating training. This is one of the most exciting trainings that we have in IMG because there's a lot of discoveries that you will find out in terms of your finances sa financial checkup coaching. Okay, let's begin. So goal setting. When you set out a goal, ito yung mga guidelines na dapat pala tinitignan natin kapag nagsiset tayo ng goals, whether it in finances, in any aspect of our life, dapat meron pala tayong mga parameters. So first, it has to be specific. Ano bang ibig sabihin? Specific goals. Say for example, one of your goals is to have, you have a savings, di ba? So, savings can be many types of savings. So, you have to be specific. Ano pong klaseng savings ang gusto mo? So, maybe one of the savings that you'd like to start up is your retirement fund. So, diba, more specific siya. instead of saying that you want to save or you want to keep aside a portion of your income, mas specific kung sasabihin natin na gusto kong umpisahan ang aking retirement fund. So you know specifically that itong savings na to ay for your retirement. Second, it has to be measurable. Okay, let's say for example, specifically you have already decided that you want to start your retirement fund. So the next question is, how much? Ano yung target mo na retirement fund? So it has to be measurable. Is it 5 million? Is it 10 million? Is it 20 million? Next, is it attainable? Say for example, if we say that or if we declare that you want to have 10 million retirement fund and you say that you want it by tomorrow, attainable ba siya or hindi? So if you set a goal, tingnan din natin, attainable ba yung goal na sinet natin? Equally the same sa attainable, is it realistic? Time bound. Okay, say for example, you've set a 20 million retirement fund. Ilang taon or how many years from now gusto mo ma-achieve yung retirement fund na yun? So dapat, you know specifically na from today up until this year or up until this month or up until this date, ko target na mabuo itong retirement fund na ito. So most people, they know that when they set a goal, it has to be smart. But IMG added two more. So for us, which is we will share with you as well, that when you set a goal, it has to be smarter. So dinagdagan natin, ano pa yung ER na dinagdag natin? So you have to evaluate your goal. Because from time to time, nagbabago yan eh. So say for example, nag-set ka ng goal ngayon, you want a 10 million retirement fund, 2 years from now, baka you realize you need more. Hindi 10 million is not enough. So you have to evaluate. Maybe by today, kaya mo napag-desisyon na 10 million ang kailangan mo is because bago pa lang tayo sa financial industry, we thought na 10 million is enough. And then 2 years from now, medyo mas marami tayong alam, mas naiintindihan na natin how to prepare for retirement. So then we realize na 10 million is not enough, you need more. So you have to evaluate your goal and then you have to re-evaluate from time to time. Why? We have to re-evaluate because nagbabago-bago din ang responsibility natin. So maybe we set a goal of a retirement fund when we are still single, di ba? Or when at the time na medyo maliit pa yung income natin, that's why yun lang yung kaya pa nating i-set aside for our retirement fund. But 2 or 3 years from now, maybe you're already married, baka meron ka ng anak, or nagbago na yung responsibility. Also, baka lumaki na yung income. So we have more capability or capacity to put more on your retirement fund. So we have to evaluate and re-evaluate our goals from time to time so that we can make sure na marireach natin yung goal na yun. Okay, let's proceed. So first step, we have to know what you want and why you want it. So lahat ng bagay, no, dapat before we step into something or before we start something, dapat very clear sa atin or naiintindihan natin bakit natin gustong ma-achieve yung goals na yun. At para malaman natin paano natin siya ma-achieve. At the same time, you know, when you set a goal, hindi naman laging smooth yung magiging journey mo in reaching that goal. So if you know your why, during times na medyo challenging na ma-reach yung goals mo, yun ang magbibigay sa'yo ng courage and extra push to proceed in achieving those goals. So know what you want and why you want it. So kami po sa IMG, we highly encourage that you write down your goals. Diba? So write down your dream list. Ano po ang dream list ninyo? You know when you decided to become part of IMG, like me, at kagaya po ng kahit sino miyembro ng IMG, lahat po tayo may mga dahilan. Diba? Magkakaiba tayo ng reason why we decided to become part of IMG, but I'm pretty sure all of us have reasons. So, ako, nakasulat po ang aking top 10 reason, my dream list, when I decided to be part of IMG. Ano yung mga gusto kong ma-achieve through my membership here? Kayo po, I highly encourage you put it down into writing para from time to time you can check it na-achieve mo na ba yung goal na yun? How near are you? Or gaya na sabi ko kanina, during times na medyo challenging achieving those goals, you just go back to your dream list to remind you why you're doing this. Okay, so at least write down your top 10 reasons. If you can write down more than that, much better. Okay, dito na tayo sa step 2. Or second thing na matututunan natin dito sa workshop na ito. So, know where you are now and what you can get with what you have. So, dito po sa training na to, malalaman natin yung tinatawag ko na SALEN. Diba? So, lahat po, every person that is that has an income or may na-accumulate na assets, ay meron pong SALEN na tinatawag. Nagkakaiba-iba lang po yan kung magkano yung figures. So, statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth. So, matutunan nyo po dito kung paano po yan i-compute. I'll walk you through it. Okay, statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth. It's very important na alam po natin how much is our net worth. Because net worth is the true measure of your wealth. Okay? Most people would think it's your assets. But we have to factor in also our liabilities. Because even if we have accumulated a lot of assets, pero nakapag-accumulate din tayo ng maraming liabilities, malalaman natin versus assets versus a liability kung magkano talaga yung net worth natin. So in this formula that I will be showing you on the next slides, mas maintindihan natin what I am talking about. Okay? So, a SALEN most likely would look like this. So, I'll show you an example. So, list down all your assets. So, there are two types of assets po, no? The first type is what we call the fixed assets. So, sample of fixed assets would be house and lot, mga real estate properties, your car, motorcycle, mga alahas, computer, gadgets, furniture, so and other personal properties. Lahat po yan ay asset, but to be more specific, we call it fixed assets. So, for sample purposes, maglalagay po ako ng figures. Okay. So, say for example, ito po ang inyong, ito po ang value ng inyong fixed assets. By the way, kapag po nilagay natin yung value ng itong ating mga fixed asset, we have to write down yung amount ng tinatawag na present market value. Ano ba yung present market value? A present market value is, say for example, sa bahay, ang amount po na ilalagay natin dito is hindi kung magkano mo nabili yung bahay or magkano kung hinuhulugan mo pa yung bahay, hindi po kung magkano na yung naihulog mo. Ang kailangan po natin ilagay na amount dito is the present market value or in case, say for example, binenta mo yung bahay ngayon, magkano siya pwedeng ibenta? Same with the car because as we all know, nagde-depreciate po ang value niyan. So, hindi natin ilalagay kung magkano mo siya binili, pero kung magkano siya pwedeng ibenta sa panahon na to. Hence, the present market value. So, say for example, your fixed assets, your total fixed assets is 2.6 million. Okay. Dito naman tayo sa tinatawag nating savings and investment. This is still part of your asset, pero this is a different type of asset naman. We call it liquid assets. So yung kanina, fixed assets, ngayon naman we call this your liquid assets. So samples of your liquid assets would be your cash on hand, magkano yung pera na hawak mo ngayon, or nasa wallet mo, or nasa bulsa mo, cash in bank, magkano yung pera na nasa banko. If you have mutual fund investments, so that includes your the interest. If you have stock investments, if you have long-term healthcare investment, memorial or life plan, life insurance, pension plan, educational plan, and then receivables. Okay. Dito naman po sa part na to, no? Say for example, sa memorial or life plan or life insurance, ang ilalagay po nating amount dito is yung tinatawag na cash surrendered value. Ano naman ibig sabihin nun? Meaning, hindi kung magkano na yung naihulog mo, ang ilalagay po natin value dito is kung in case ito-terminate mo yung plan, magkano po yung ibabalik sa iyong halaga. So that's part of your asset. Gusto ko lang din po i-clarify itong sa receivables, that is the last part. So loans you have given that you are sure you can collect. So ibig sabihin, ang i-declare lang po natin sa receivables are the amount na pinahiram natin pero sigurado tayong babayaran pa. Okay, so that's all part of your assets or your liquid assets. Okay, so let's say for example, you have 80,000 worth of liquid assets. So we total that up, the total amount of your personal properties or your fixed assets plus the total amount of your savings and investment or your liquid assets. So kung gagamitin po natin yung figures na pinakita ko kanina, the total amount of your assets or your total assets would be 2.6 million or 2,680,000. Okay, so tapos na tayo dun sa assets. Now, pag-aralan naman natin yung liabilities. Diba? To get your net worth, you have to factor in your liabilities. So, ano ba yung mga sample ng liabilities? It can be yung mortgage ng bahay, kung naka-housing loan siya, credit card balance, car loan balance, bank loans that is still to be paid, appliances loan, payables for utilities, anything na kailangan mo pa pumbayaran, no? In credit. So, say for example, ang common na tanong dito is, paano kung meron akong bahay? Pero hindi ko pa siya fully paid. I-declare po natin yun as asset, gaya nung nabanggit ko kanina, as present market value. But since hindi pa siya fully paid, kailangan po natin i-declare sa portion ng liabilities kung magkano pa po yung kailangan nating bayaran. So the easiest way para po masagutan yan o malaman ninyo magkano pa actually yung kailangan nating bayaran is, say for example, you're paying on a monthly basis. Magkano yung binabayad mo monthly? Multiply that to how many more months mo pa siya kailangang hulugan. So, dun mo malalaman magkano pa yung mortgage mo. And, lagay lang din natin what's the amount in case meron kang credit card balance, so on and so forth. And kung meron man dito mga loans na wala po sa listahan, just put it on other loans. Okay? So, for sample purposes, lagyan po natin ang figures. Say, for example, you have, your total liability would be 2.7 million. So, computein natin ngayon yung inyong net worth. Okay. For you to be able to compute your net worth is very easy. So, your total asset minus your liabilities is your net worth. Okay? So, balikan natin yung figures kanina. Your total asset is 2.6 million minus your total liabilities, which is 2.7 million. So, if you notice, di ba, negative pa yung net worth natin. Negative 20,000. Di ba? So, para i-analyze to, no, just check how many years have you been working. Diba? So, kung ano man yung value sa ating net worth, it only shows na ito po yung na-accumulate nating wealth. Gaya na sabi ko kanina, your net worth is your true measure of wealth. So, mas mataas yung liabilities natin kesa sa assets natin, ibig sabihin, negative pa yung ating net worth. So, the question is, anong plano natin para pataasin yung assets at para mapagbaba yung liabilities? Diba? So most people, they don't know that na ganito yung kanilang net worth until they undergo financial checkup. Same po sa akin. When I first came to IMG, I attended the first seminar and then after that went straight to financial checkup. At that time, although I have investments, hindi ko alam na ako pala ay negative. I think negative by 1.2 million because of real estate property na ako na akin pong inacquire. So mas mataas pa yung mortgage na binabayaran ko kaysa dun sa value ng aking investment. Okay? So, ganun po ka-importante ang financial checkup. Okay, so, in this, if you notice, ang title po nating training as financial checkup and goal setting. So, ibig sabihin, we will show you what would be the procedure para malaman natin what's the status of our net worth. And also, the same as with your cash flow. Pero, in the end of the training, we will show you or we will give you advices kung paano natin may improve yung status ng ating net worth and cash flow. Okay, know why you're in your present situation. So, kung negative yung net worth natin, tingnan natin. Bakit naging negative yung result na ating net worth? So, malalaman natin yun kung paano natin hinahandle yung finances natin on a monthly basis. So, ang titingnan natin ngayon is your cash flow statement. Okay, so a cash flow statement more or less would look like this. Okay, so portion by portion natin siyang tingnan. So, an example of household expense. This is part of our basic expense. Lahat po tayo ay may ganitong klaseng expense. So, grocery, kumbaga. O, dun muna tayo sa food expense. Halimbawa, no, a meal per person would cost 50 pesos each. So, for a family of three, meaning yung mag-asawa plus one child, no, 50 pesos per meal times three, they're tatlo sila, and then obviously, they're eating at least three times a day. So, that's 50 pesos per meal times three meals multiplied to three family members. So, ang food cost nila or food expense nila in a day is at least 450 pesos. So, let's multiply that by 30 days for a month. So, in a month, they have at least 13,500 pesos expense for food alone. Dagdag natin yung other expenses like groceries, snacks, toiletries, cleaning items sa bahay. So, sabihin na lang natin roughly around 6,500 pesos yan. Ibig sabihin, ang total monthly expense mo would be around 20,000 per month. Okay, so now let's proceed with your expenses. So say for example, ang monthly expenses mo, I would suggest, no, for your expenses, ang gamitin natin is yung pinaka-recent na month. Like, say for example, ngayon ay November, halimbawa lang. So, ang gagamitin natin, kalagitnaan halimbawa ng November ngayon. So, ang gamitin natin is yung recent month, which is October. Para nang sa ganun, medyo fresh pa sa mind natin yung mga naging expense natin at that time. Hindi natin pwedeng gamitin yung present month kasi hindi pa naman tapos yung expenses natin for this month, right? So, I would highly suggest though na wag natin gamitin yung month of December kasi medyo hindi ganun ka-normal yung way ng spending ng mga tao kapag December because of the holidays. Medyo maraming expenses yan. So, from January to November, okay lang siyang gamitin. So, write down para saan, anong month yung ginamit natin, and then write down what would be your basic expenses. So, that includes yung household mo, yung food expense, the groceries, gaya ng mga pinakita kong expenses kanina, house rental, magkano yung binabayad natin in case nagre-rent pa tayo ng bahay, how much would be your normal or average electricity bill, water bill, and other bills that we are paying on a monthly basis, landline, mobile phone, internet, kung nakalinya tayo sa mobile, di ba, magkano yung binabayaran natin monthly. Kung meron tayong mga maintenance expenses, say for example, repairs ng car or ng aircon, so magkano yung binayad natin last month. Transportation, how much is your transportation allowance? Medicine, food supplements, so magkano yung allowance na inaalat natin ng monthly. Shoes, clothes, kung meron tayong binili the recent month, magkano yung nagastos natin doon. Salary for housekeeper, so magkano yung monthly salary na binibigay natin. Tuition, books, allowances, projects, kung meron tayong pinag-aaral. So, magkano yung naging expense natin doon? Or tayo, kung tayo mismo ay nag-aaral pa, so magkano yung mga nagagastos natin for the books, for the tuition fee? Kung meron mga expenses dyan na hindi natin binabayaran on a monthly basis. Say, for example, ano pang pwede maging example dito? Halimbawa, tuition fee. Hindi naman natin yan monthly binabayaran, right? So, more or less per sem. So, say for example, binayaran natin siya ng June. Sample lang ha. So, isang bagsakan lang natin siya binayaran, right? So, you just total it up and then divide it into 12. So, para makita mo more or less, what's your average monthly expense for that type of expense. And then, you total that up. That would be your total basic expenses. So, halimbawa, ayan ang sample computation ng iyong basic expense. So, let's move on naman dun sa tinatawag natin na other expenses, like yung mga discretionary expenses or yung mga debts, mga loans, insurances. So, say for example, your basic expense, yung kinumpute natin kanina, that would be 39,000. Yung mga binabayaran natin monthly na mga loans or kung meron tayong insurances, ito pala yung best example para dun sa naging computation kanina, no? Halimbawa, insurance, di ba? Once a year mo siyang binabayaran. So, you're on an annual mode of payment. So, paano makukuha magkano ang monthly expense mo doon? So, how much are you paying in a year? Then, divide that into 12. So, you will know magkano yung monthly expense mo for that. And then, optional expenses. What would be yung optional expenses? Halimbawa, OFW ka, magkano yung pinapadala mo sa Pilipinas? or magkano ini-spend mo to probably watch a movie. So those are optional expense, or go out, dining out. So yan, yan yung mga samples na optional expenses. So kung ang basic expense mo is 39,000, and then yung other expenses mo is 29,000, meaning your total expenses in a month would be roughly around 68,000. Okay. As to compare to that, tingnan natin how much is your monthly income. So paano mo makukuha naman ang iyong monthly income? Yung monthly income mo is your salary from yung sa job mo or sa trabaho mo. So monthly na kukuha natin yan. If you have other sources of income like businesses, probably investments. So those are all types of income. So total that up and then malalaman natin what would be your total monthly income. So say for example, ang salary mo is this much. And then you don't have another source of income. So zero lang lagay natin dyan. So your total monthly income would be 50,000. So, para makita natin kung magkano ang cash flow mo, meron ba or wala, ito po yung formula. So, the formula for us to know what is our cash flow is yung total income mo, total monthly income, minus your total monthly expense, you will know how much is your cash flow on a monthly basis. So, itong sample na binigay ko is, ang total monthly income niya is 50,000. Pero, ang total monthly expense niya is 68,000. So, it's very obvious. Mas malaki yung expenses niya as compared dun sa kanyang income. So, every month, negative 18,000 siya. Can you guess saan niya kinukuha yung 18,000 na yun? More or less, ito po ay naka-loan or probably sa credit card. Diba? So, negative cash flow siya. This specifically answers kung bakit ang kanyang sal-in of state net of assets, liabilities, and net worth, ang net worth niya is negative. Okay? Evaluate naman natin kung ano yung present situation mo and that what would be the solution. Gaya nung sabi ko sa inyo kanina, the purpose of having this financial checkup is for us to find out where are you in terms of your finances. And obviously, to give you also advice or suggestion, anong pwede natin gawin dun sa present situation mo. So, first situation, halimbawa positive ang net worth mo, positive din ang cash flow mo. What does it mean? It only shows that you're in a good situation. You have extra money to start your investment plan. So, as early as now, pwede natin umpisahan what would be your, ang pag-build ng yung solid financial foundation. So, ang solution natin is to grow and protect what you already have. Diba, meron ka ng positive na yung net worth mo, positive na yung cash flow mo, ang pwede natin gawin is palaguin pa yun at the same time, protektahan. So, get into financial industry. So, second sample of situation is, negative yung net worth mo, at the same time, negative din yung cash flow mo. So, kung ganito yung sitwasyon mo ngayon, ang ibig sabihin is, you are in a challenging situation. Hindi naman sinasabing difficult or impossible na gawa ng solusyon, pero medyo challenging siya. So, you are living beyond your means. Although it's a challenging situation, may solution pa rin naman dyan. So, the solution is to live below your means, meaning look at your expenses, kung saan ka pa kayang, o saan mo pa kayang mag-cut down, especially dun sa optional expenses. Kung pwede, kung tingnan mo kung alin dun yung mga pwede mong i-cut out, diba? And then, pagsabayin itong dalawang steps na to, pataasin mo pa yung income mo, meaning kung ang source of income mo ngayon ay isa lang, your salary, find other ways to have additional source of income. So, pataasin mo yung income mo at the same time, pababain mo yung expenses mo. And then eventually, definitely, your cash flow and then your net worth will become positive. Okay, third type of situation, paano kung positive yung net worth mo pero negative ang cash flow mo? Anong ibig sabihin niyan? Ito yung sitwasyon mo. You are spending more than what you earn and you're using some of your assets to pay for your expenses. Ibig sabihin, positive yung net worth mo, negative yung cash flow mo. So, ang ibig sabihin, yung negativity ng cash flow mo, dun mo kinukuha sa savings mo na or investment mo. So, the solution would be, do not spend more than what you earn. Pataasin yung income at the same time, lower down your expenses. Kumbaga, yung nilagay mo sa sal and more dun sa net worth mo, dapat pinoprotect mo na yun, ginugrow mo na yun. Hindi mo siya dapat ginagamit for your present needs. Okay? The last type of sal-in would be like this. Negative yung net worth, pero positive yung cash flow. Ano namang ibig sabihin yan? You have some money or extra money, but you are not paying your debts or liabilities. Delikado yan. Lalo na kung may interest yung utang. So, ang priority dapat natin is, every time you have extra money, gamitin mo dapat yun para mabilis na mabayaran yung utang mo. Lalo na, like what I've said, kung mataas or merong interest yung utang natin. So the solution would be to pay off your debt, increase your income, and lower down your expenses. So can you imagine, no? Meron kang investment with an interest, pero mas mataas yung interest ng utang mo. So ibig sabihin lang nun, kinakain nung interest ng utang mo yung interest ng investment mo. So that is not a healthy or a wise strategy. Okay, number four. Know what you can get with what you have. Diba? Tinignan natin what's your net worth. Siguro by now, kung sinundan nyo yung step, more or less, alam mo na what's your net worth. And then, tinignan na rin natin kung magkano ang iyong cash flow. So based on the net worth that you have right now, and based on the cash flow that you have right now, anong pwede nating makuha from that? Ano ang pwede nating umpisahan? Okay? So say for example, di ba sabi ko kanina, when you set out a goal, you have to be specific. Halimbawa, one of those goals is your retirement fund. Sabi natin kanina, it has to be time-bound. So dapat, when is your deadline for that retirement fund? So say for example, your deadline is 10 years from now. Okay, and then magkano yung sinet mong goal for your retirement fund? So say for example, you're targeting to have 1 million retirement fund 10 years from now. So very specific yung goal, di ba? So tingnan natin. What if with what you have right now, meaning your cash flow, you can only save or invest 10,000 per month for the next 10 years? Titingnan natin, kaya bang ma-reach yung goal na 1 million? So kung i-invest mo yung 1,000 pesos na yan per month at 4%, after 10 years, 147,000 lang siya. And 147,250. So hindi mo na-reach yung goal mo. Kung i-invest natin siya sa 12%, after 10 years, yung 1,000 per month mong ini-invest will become 247,855. Kulang pa rin siya, hindi ba? So now, you have an option na i-shrink na lang ng size ng dream mo. Halimbawa, ang dream mo is, di ba, 1 million after 10 years. Kaya lang, 1,000 lang ang kaya mo per month. So instead na 1 million, paligitin na lang natin yung dream natin. Gawin na lang natin siya 147 or 247,000. Gusto mo ba yun? Siyempre, ayaw natin yun. Kaya nga tayo nag-IMG, di ba? Para malaman natin paano natin ma-achieve yung goals natin. But most people would settle for this. Diba? 1,000 lang talaga kaya kong ipunin eh. Hindi nila alam na isinusugal nila yung sarili nilang dream simply because ayaw nilang gawa ng paraan na yung 1,000 na yun ay mas palakikin. When in fact, marami namang paraan eh. Diba? Second situation. Another option is, i-adjust mo yung deadline mo. So, 1,000 lang talaga kaya per month. Pero, extend mo siya into 20 years. Kanina, 10 years yung deadline natin. Ito, after 20 years. Kung invest mo yan sa 4%, 370,000 lang. So, hindi mo pa rin na-reach yung goal mo. Pero, kung invest mo siya sa 12%, na-hit mo yung goal mo na 1 million. Kaya lang, you have to extend yung time na kailangan mo magtrabaho at mag-ipon at mag-invest. You even have to double yung years na kailangan mo intayin para ma-reach mo yung goal mo. So the second option is adjust your deadline. Diba? Meron tayong third option na para sa akin is the best option among these three. What if from 1,000, pababain pa natin yung expense natin, gawa natin ng paraan para mas kumita ng additional income, mapataas natin yung investment natin from 1,000 to 5,000 pesos per month for the next 10 years. Sa 4%, medyo fall short ka pa dyan. Yung 5,000 per month mo for the next 10 years will become 736,250. But if you put it at 12%, it will become 1.2 million. So the third option is to increase the amount of savings. Kung kayong tatanungin, would you rather shrink the size of your dream, adjust the deadline, or increase the amount of savings? Para sa akin, mas kaya ata nating gawa ng paraan na mas palakihin, especially if you're still young and you have active income. Disiplina lang naman ang sagot dito eh. para mapataas natin yung monthly savings natin so that ma-reach natin yung goal natin on a proper deadline. Okay, number 6. Know how to get what you want. So, what's your plan to accomplish the 6 steps to building a solid financial foundation? Diba, kung I'm assuming na napanood na natin ang ating The Secrets of Saving and Building Your Future orientation, doon diniscuss natin or like me, doon namulat ang aking doon ako namulat sa proper way of building wealth. So, kung napanood na natin yun, alam na natin, we're very much familiar already with what we want to achieve in ING, that is to build a solid financial foundation. Walang taong may ayaw niyan. All of us, maybe hindi lang tayo aware, but this is what we want to achieve during retirement. Diba? Kaya lang, ano ang concrete plan natin para ma-achieve yun? Okay, step 1. This is just a review, pero gusto nating diinan ng konti. Increase your cash flow to fund your solid financial foundation. You know, there's a very important reason kung bakit ito yung first step, increasing your cash flow. You know, without cash flow, like yung pinakita ko kanina, negative 20,000. Kung negative 20,000 tayo every month, ano ang pang-fund natin to your healthcare protection, life insurance, anong saan tayo kuha ng pambayad ng utang, anong pambuo natin ng emergency fund, at the same time, anong i-invest natin sa mutual funds or stock market. So, it is very very simple kung iintindihin natin bakit ang first step is to increase your cash flow. Diba? Ito yung ating raw material sa pang-build ng ating solid financial foundation. Step 2. Provide proper protection. First, for your health. If you're the breadwinner of the family, bigla kang magkasakit, dapat meron tayong healthcare fund para nasa ganon, hindi natin kunin sa investment natin yung pampagamot natin. Diba? For your family or life insurance, in case a breadwinner dies too soon at hindi pa niya na-build yung wealth niya, at least malaki yung amount na may iwan niya sa pamilya niya. And also for your properties and businesses, mga non-life insurances. Ayaw naman natin yung mga binild nating fixed assets like house, other properties, even our businesses. Pag nagkaroon ng calamity, ay hindi siya protected. So, we should provide proper protection para nang sa ganun, while we are building our wealth, which takes time, ay tayo ay properly protected kahit ano man ang mangyari. Okay, step 3, pay off your debts and then create emergency fund. Anong purpose nitong step 3 and 4? That is to protect your investments. Gaya ng nabanggit ko kanina, it should be one of our priority to zero out our debt, lalo na kung may interest po yung utang na yan. Because baka mas mataas pa yung interest ng utang sa interest ng ating investment. So, kinakain lang ng interest ng utang natin, yung interest ng investment. Emergency fund will actually save you from borrowing money because in the event na halimbawa, magkaroon ka ng emergency, like say for example, mawalan ka ng work, that's an emergency, hindi mo kailangan mangutang na pera. Meron kang enough fund or allowance for you to be able to get another job or another source of income. An emergency fund will also save you from pulling out your investment. Diba? Kasi kung meron tayong investment but we don't have an emergency fund, emergency happens, hindi mo nga kailangan manghiram ng pera but you have to pull out your investment. So back to zero na naman yung savings mo. So ganun siya ka-importante. And then step number 5, we have to learn how to invest properly. Saan yung 12%, saan yung 4% so that for us to be able to reach our financial goals. Okay? So basically, in the next tutorials, marami pang trainings after this. In the next videos, financial coachings as well, matututunan natin paano natin slowly marireach ang ating financial goals. So, most people did not plan to fail. They simply failed to plan. Diba? Kaya nga tayo may goal setting ngayon eh. And I'm directly asking you, what's your plan to build a solid financial foundation? Because everyone wants to build a solid financial foundation. But not everyone are achieving it. One major factor is because they failed to plan. Bakit kaya sila nag-fail to plan? Well, one reason is that hindi nila alam kung paano eh. So, most people love to plan for wedding, for party, birthday parties, next vacation, next day off, travel, pero hindi pinaghahandaan solid financial foundation and retirement. So kung ikaw ang tatanungin ko, anong plano mo? Diba? So I'd like to think that you want to build a solid financial foundation. That's why you're having this training right now. And lahat naman tayo, yun ang ma-achieve natin. Kung i-apply lang natin kung ano yung pinag-aaralan natin today. Okay, so know if you can get what you want. So you have to undergo regular financial checkup, evaluate it and re-evaluate it. Gaya po kami, no? My first financial checkup was in September 2012, gaya nga na nakwento ko kanina. And as suggested, we undergo financial checkup minimum at least once a year. Pero ang pinakamaganda po talaga is at least every 6 months. Because by attending these trainings and by applying what you're learning, magbabago po talaga ang status ng finances mo. And the best way for you to see kung anong mga nagbabago, what are the changes or what are the improvements in terms of your financial life, is to undergo regular financial checkup. Doon mo makikita, tumataas na ba yung net worth? Or kung yung dating negative, nagiging positive na ba? How's your cash flow 6 months from now? Diba? So we have to check that from time to time. Okay, kung ikaw ang papipiliin, what would you choose? Would you be willing to sacrifice now and enjoy later? Or would you rather enjoy now and suffer later? So, common nating naririnig ngayon, no, yung term na YOLO, you only live once. So, you have to enjoy the moment. But we also have to remember that we also grow old, right? So, kung yun yung susundin natin, we enjoy now and there's nothing wrong about enjoying the moment. But not to the point na lahat ng kinikita natin, na iubusin natin, bahala na bukas. Diba? So, sacrificing now meaning set a portion of your income so that pagdating mo ng old age, ay hindi ka naman kailangan manghingi sa iba. Diba? So a little sacrifice now and then eventually you'll be able to enjoy kung ano man yung iyong na-save or na-invest. Instead of ubusin natin lahat ng ating kinita ngayon and then eventually hindi natin alam kung saan tayo kukuha. And I'm pretty sure wala naman sa atin ay may gusto during the retirement, ito ang kalalabasan natin. Okay, so a little sacrifice now is okay. Okay, so 4 basic financial mistakes. Number 1 is lack of financial plan. Diba, gaya nung nabanggit ko kanina, maraming bagay ang kayang paghandaan, pero in terms of the finances, parang ayaw pag-isipan. Diba? Second is lack of discipline and procrastination. Ano ibig sabihin yan? People think they have a lot of time to let, they have enough time left to work for their dreams. With too many excuses, they cannot start to plan. Diba? Nag-start ng work at 20s, ang daming excuses. Ah, bata pa naman ako, matagal pa naman ako magre-retire, saka na ako mag-iipon. 10 years later, 20 years later, wala pa rin naumpisahan. Number 3, depend on someone else. Diba? Ayaw mag-take charge about their finances. So people don't want to take responsibility of their finances. Mas gusto nila ibang tao ang nag-aasikaso ng pera nila. That's why umaasa sa agent. But, you know, we have to be realistic about this. Wala pong ibang magiging concern sa pera natin more than us. Because wala pong mas makakaintindi kung paano natin pinaghirapang kitain yung pera na yan as to compare to us. So, mas maganda, we take charge, intindihin natin paano palalaguin or paano puprotektahan yung pera pinaghirapan natin. Para nang sa ganun, we can decide properly kung saan natin siya o paano natin siya isi-safekeep at i-grow. And then number 4, lack of financial knowledge. Okay, you will likely to make same mistakes in the future if you fail to increase your financial intelligence. So we are very blessed. And one thing I'm very grateful for being part of ING is because I've learned a lot of financial concepts and strategies na hindi ko siya natutunan sa school, hindi siya naituro ng parents, or hindi ko siya natutunan sa kahit anong seminar or any books. Diba? So dito ko siya natutunan, na-apply ko sa life ko, and then eventually, it really resulted to a solid financial foundation. So the first step is really to increase our financial intelligence. We have to understand how to handle and how to grow our money. Okay, number 7, know what it takes to get what you want. Diba? We want to achieve something. The best way to be able to achieve that goal is to understand or hanapin natin yung paraan paano natin ma-achieve yung goal na yun. So, we are who we are today because of choices we made early on in our lives. Say, for example, if a person is indebted right now, it is a result of a decision to borrow money before. Diba? Lack of discipline. If a person is financially well right now, it is a result of a decision that person made earlier na mag-ipon, to be diligent, magtabi ng portion ng income niya, diba? So basically, kung, gaya ng sinabi dito, kung ano man yung present situation natin ngayon in terms of finances, resulta yun ng mga naging decision natin from the past. So the question is, are you in good situation right now or in a bad situation in terms of your finances? Balikan natin, ano pa yung mga naging sitwasyon or decision natin before na posibleng naging result nung present situation natin ngayon. So, what we will be tomorrow depends on the choices we make today. So, it's one thing na dapat alam natin ano yung mga mali natin ginawa so that hindi na natin siya ulitin. Diba? So, balikan natin yung goals na nilagay mo dun sa first part of this training. May mga goals tayo, right? So, you have to make the decision today and we have to make the right decisions today kung paano natin ma-achieve yun. So, what will be those decisions? Sinabi ko na yan kanina. Depende ko anong sitwasyon ng net worth and ng cash flow mo. Kung positive, parehong positive, protektahan natin or i-grow pa natin yung pera. Kung negative yung cash flow, so kailangan natin i-increase yung ating income and lower down your expense. I've already given you the advices, so all we need to do is to decide na gawin yun at sundin yung advice. So build your future the way you want it. Ikaw lang naman din ang makakapagsabi ko, how do you actually picture your future? Paano mo ba siya nakikita? Most of us wants a secure and comfortable future. So kung ganun mo siya nakikita, let's do something para ma-achieve natin yun. So you're just one wrong decision away from poverty. Ibig sabihin, if you decide to spend all your money right now, that is definitely a very wrong decision and it will eventually lead you to poverty. If you decide to spend more than above your means, so that will lead you to poverty eventually. And what's good news is, you only one right decision to become wealthy. So everything boils down to decision right now. Will you decide to, like suggested, keep 10% of your or 20% of your income for investment every month, di ba? Decision yan eh. Will you decide right now kung medyo indebted tayo? Will you start deciding right now na umpisahan ng bayaran slowly but surely ang ating utang para eventually ay mag-zero out na yung debt? Emergency, hindi natin alam kailan yan mangyayari. So, if you will decide right now to start your emergency fund, by the time emergency happens, meron ka emergency fund, so you'll be grateful for that day na nag-decide ka na umpisahan yung emergency fund mo kasi by that time, meron kang mauhugot. So, ulitin ko lang because it's a very good line, you're only one right decision to becoming wealthy. Yan. Procrastination. It is one of the main causes of failure. Yung lagi nating pinagpapaliban, di ba? Alam naman natin na ito yung dapat gawin, pero saka na lang, next year na lang, after ko na lang medyo makaluwag-luwag, maybe kapag nagkaroon ako ng increase sa trabaho, saka ko na lang tuumpisahan. You know, this question is very straightforward and very important kung i-analyze natin properly. If you know you're going to do this later, why not do this now? Kung alam mo mag-iipon ka na rin lang naman today or eventually, bakit hindi pa ngayon? Kung alam mo eventually gusto mo rin namang ma-zero out yung utang mo, ba't di pa natin umpisahan ngayon? Diba? So again, procrastination is one of the main causes of failure. Okay, so I encourage you to take action now in terms of your finances. So, whether you're ready or not, umpisahan na natin. So, the only way for you to understand and to know how to do it is to give it a try or umpisahan natin, di ba? Mas malalim yung pag-intindi natin once ina-apply na natin sa finances natin. Say, for example, investment. If you're reading books about investment, if you're watching videos about investment, somehow naiintindihan natin. But once you actually fill up the forms, start a procedure, mas deeper yung learnings and your understanding on. Especially kapag kumikita ng investments natin. So, mas na-appreciate na natin siya. So, the details of your own path will never be totally clear until you start acting on it. So sabi nga ni Confucius, the journey of a thousand miles begins with a single step. I will always repeat, building wealth takes time. And although it will take time bago natin ma-achieve yung wealth na inasam natin or ang goal natin, no? It always starts with one decision, one step forward. And then dire-diretso, hindi natin mamamalayan kung talagang we are very focused doing so. Hindi natin mamalayan na achieve na pala natin yung goal na tinarget natin at the beginning. So begin. Okay, so that's the end of our financial checkup and goal setting workshop. I hope you learned something. At least by now, we are assuming na we'd like to claim na you already know how to compute your SALN and your net worth. At least by now, we know with this training na alam na natin kung paano natin kukumpitin ang ating cash flow. And then we highly suggest, like what I've mentioned earlier, we do this on a regular basis, minimum once a year or at least every 6 months. Okay? So see you in our next financial coachings. Tuloy-tuloy lang tayo in learning how to build a solid financial foundation at the same time applying what we're learning. Okay, so that's the end of our training. Happy journey towards financial freedom.